Cool Movie Ratings, and today I am doing a review for one of my favorite movies of all time, Beverly Hills Cop. Now, this is a movie that I watched probably about 2 months ago, and ever since I watched it, I immediately loved it. So, this is going to be part of my Wednesday-Saturday uploads for the entire month of June. Guys, let's start this review. But before I talk about anything else in this review, I'm going to talk about Eddie Murphy himself, the star of this movie, as Axel Foley. Axel Foley, I must add, is one of the most iconic characters of all time, and I think I even knew his name before I even watched the movie. And Eddie Murphy is freaking great in this movie. So a lot of people who are in comedy movies are known as the people who can't do very good acting. I hate that stereotype because a lot of people thought stuff with Adam Sandler. I haven't seen it, but I hear like Uncut Gems and stuff is good. But Eddie Murphy is actually a really good actor. And I know he has some dramatic roles that I really want to watch. But he's great in this as Axel Foley. And a lot of other people who are in the movie are the guy from RoboCop. I forget his name right now. He's a lieutenant, and he's a really good side character. But two of my favorite side characters of all time are Billy and Taggart. And I know Billy's played by Judge Reinhold. I forget who Taggart is played by, but those are two of the best side characters of all time in any movie. They're such a great duo to be with Eddie Murphy through the movie, but Eddie Murphy excels at this. He's so funny, and it totally works in every single scene, and I think that he might be the best comedy actor ever, in my opinion. He's up there with Adam Sandler, in my opinion, but I freaking love this movie. Other stuff that's good, I think this is the part that a lot of people recognize, and it should be recognized, the music. In my opinion, this might be the best movie score ever. It's definitely the most known, because once I started to hear it, I was like, I've heard this before, and it's in a lot of other stuff. It's the do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I had it playing at the beginning of the review, but this is a freaking great soundtrack to the movie. And the guy who made it actually made the Running Man score, which I really like a lot. I just rewatched the Running Man, actually, and it was really good. And his name is Harold Faltermeyer, I'm pretty sure. He's an amazing composer, and I feel like he should be more recognized because I think it was like the first song to hit the charts or something crazy like that back in 1984. But other great things about this movie is the way it's shot by the cinematographer. It's always funny. Like, I think the beginning scene has very good cinematography. How it shows him, like, flying around in the back of the truck. And this is a great movie. And like I said about the score, the music, the actual songs, I'm pretty sure every single one, it might be in my top 15 favorite songs. Because the song Stir It Up, after watching this movie, I'd heard it before, and I think it was in the movie Chicken Little, and I recognize it, but it was some kind of remake that wasn't as good in Chicken Little. But once actually watching the movie, it became my favorite song, and so the song Stir It Up is one of my it is my favorite song, and if you haven't listened to it, it's by Patti LaBelle. It's a great song, go listen to it. And then one of my other favorite songs in this movie that I feel like it's the most known song for this movie is The Heat Is On. That's the one that gets stuck in my head the most. Glenn Frey is great singing that one. There's not a lot of stuff that's bad about this movie. None of it I can think of. And the guy who's the bad guy, I can't think of him right now, but he's like rich, and he's a very he's a good villain. And the end shootout is a very good scene, and it's kind of funny because even when it's trying to be serious, it also inserts comedy that completely works. Like Billy and Taggart, like, I'm pretty sure Taggart's pushing Billy up, and then Axel's just watching because there's just like steps to go up, and they're pushing him up, like, and he's like struggling, and then he's just laughing. It's a great scene, in my opinion. And the director, I'm pretty sure, is Martin Brest. And after watching some videos on the behind the scenes, he didn't want to do the movie at first. After he did, he was gonna direct one of my other favorite movies of all time, War Games, but he got removed from it, and he didn't really want to do directing anymore, like, for a while. But he accepted, and he's a great director in it. And I want to know the cinematographer's name, because like I said earlier, he's, whoever it is, he or she, they did an amazing job doing the cinematography in this movie. The jokes, like I said, the comedy always hits. It's not, it's never any, like, it feels like kind of like comedy that's not needed. I think it's all great. And I think the plot is very interesting. Like, it's not a terribly basic plot, but it's not like a very complicated plot either. But I just think the idea of this guy who worked for this really rich man comes back and he steals some stuff, but then he gets, technically it's kind of like Hitman come after him, kill him, and then his friend goes to Beverly Hills and tries to find this guy and see if he's guilty, because nobody believes him in him being guilty, the bad guy. And in the end, he actually gets proof, and then he gets sent to jail, I'm pretty sure. And it's a freaking great movie. If you haven't seen it already, I 100% recommend it. It's from 1984, which you gotta go look at my Instagram. I post daily stuff on there about me, like, out of not just movies, and also a lot of it is about movies. And I put the best year in movie history, in my opinion, is 1984, and you can read the list of all the movies that I have listed, and this is definitely one of them. So thank you guys so much for watching this review. This was a fun review to do, because I think this movie, if you're having kind of like a bad day or sad day and you watch it, it just makes you feel a tiny bit better. And this movie is amazing, like I said. It's one of my favorites. It's my favorite comedy movie of all time, hands down. But if you haven't seen this, definitely go watch it. And thank you guys so much for watching this review. It's a cool movie rating, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.
They're gonna kill us.
You guys. If you fall too far behind, don't be afraid to honk, okay?
Where are we going anyway?
Don't worry about it. Just follow my lead. I know the perfect place. You guys will love it. Trust me.